Making headlines, Labour Minister clears up social media rumours. Police appeal for information in recent Grand Turk shooting. And the TCI records its 16th COVID-19 death. Hey there, Turks and Caicos. I am Delana Owls with your Monday, March 22nd edition of Newswatch. The news starts now. Minister of Immigration and Labour, the Honourable Arlington Musgrove, has issued a response to a WhatsApp message that insinuated that 200 Vincentian nationals will be coming to work in the TCI. Here's what he had to say.
Minister of Immigration Honorable Arlington Musgrove says rumors of 200 Vincentians said to become fully employed by Sandals Resort Beaches TCI is baseless. However, says that the St. Vincent Nationals are to be placed at the various Sandals properties on a temporary basis. The message circulating across WhatsApp has caused some uproar over local employment numbers versus the reported 200 migrants to be sent to the resorts. Musgrove replied saying, quote, "I can assure you that we have not had any discussions along these lines, and in the event we do, we will always look out for the betterment of our people first." In receiving the message, it speaks of a possible attachment of Beaches personnel at their various resorts to gain the requisite knowledge and skills to return to St. Vincent to work at the newly acquired resort once it is completed and ready for opening. The minister goes on to say, while this may be their plan, it is certainly not the plan of this government when we have so many Turks and Caicos Islanders who are out of work presently. Musgrove continues, with that being said, we must also look at a reciprocal arrangement for our people so they too can benefit from such an exchange where they would leave the Turks and Caicos Islands and be posted on a temporary basis at other Sandals Beaches properties to further enhance their overall growth and development, end quote. Officials are said to arrange a meeting with Beaches TCI to discuss this matter further in order to provide the public with an update.
Last Thursday, Premier Honorable Charles Washington Missick attended the 10th UK Caribbean Forum hosted by the UK Foreign, Commonwealth and Development Office. The virtual forum brought together foreign ministers from the UK and CARICOM with a common aim to strengthen cooperation between the UK and Caribbean countries, among other things. The forum also provides an opportunity to discuss bilateral, regional and global issues at a ministerial level. This year's discussions were led by Lord Tariq Ahmad. He is the Minister of State for the Commonwealth and United Nations at the Foreign Commonwealth Development Office. The three main areas of focus were economy, environment, and values and security. The forum heard from various country leaders and received a special message from the Prince of Wales, Charles Philip Arthur George. In a press statement after the meeting, the Premier noted that a representation of Turks and Caicos Islands at a meeting of this level is necessary to ensure not only that this country has an opportunity to promote its brand, but also to hear from other ministerial leaders their best practices and to discuss major global and regional matters, including economic growth, national security, and the management of the COVID-19 pandemic. Premier Missick states that it is important that the TCI not only show its strength as a leading country in the Caribbean, but that it is equally as important to build mutually beneficial relationships with countries in the region and across the globe. The Premier says the ultimate goal is to ensure that the people of the Turks and Caicos Islands can thrive and prosper. He adds that the meeting was very productive and insightful, adding that his government will continue to work to ensure that the TCI ascends in upward growth. The forum is a biennial event, with the UK and a Caribbean country hosting alternatively. The UK overseas territories are invited as participatory observers to the forum by the UK. Discussions during the forum was captured in a joint communique and an action plan which was signed digitally. The next forum will take place in 2023 in the Caribbean. A quick commercial break now, but more news when we come back.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza Providence Jollies, Midas Plaza North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. The victim of that shooting incident in the nation's capital on Thursday has been identified, and police are appealing to the public for information surrounding that ordeal.
Sixty-six-year-old Fred Russell Bryan, also known as Yardy, was the person shot to death during a robbery at Garcia's Bar on Frith Street, Grand Turk, on Thursday evening. Police are still appealing for the public's help with finding his murderer after a search warrant was issued for a premises in Breezy Bray, where a firearm was recovered, but brought no connections to the Thursday night incident. Police received the call at 8:40 p.m. and are trying to piece together what happened moments before. Investigators are appealing for information from anyone who was near the bar or Good Street between 8 p.m. and 9 p.m. on Thursday. Investigations also continue into that murder on Miller Clark Avenue on December 27, 2020, and another on January 1st, where 50-year-old Vanel Jacks was found with what appeared to be blunt force trauma to the head. Anyone with information regarding any of these crimes is asked to come forward.
Airbnb and the Caribbean Tourism Organization recently launched a campaign to promote tourism to the Turks and Caicos Islands and other Caribbean destinations. LaToya Walk-In reports.
After almost a year of intermittent travel restrictions, Airbnb, the Caribbean Tourism Organization, CTO, and Turks and Caicos are collaborating to amplify the country's recovery from the impacts of COVID-19 by promoting responsible travel to the destination across Airbnb's vast global community. As part of this alliance, Airbnb and CTO are launching a campaign leveraging Airbnb's robust media platforms to market Turks and Caicos and other CTO member countries to millions of engaged Airbnb users. The campaign rollout includes a series of email letters, a landing page, and ads on social media showcasing Airbnb listings in the Turks and Caicos, as well as the existing protocols for safe travel during this time. The promotional landing page for this partnership will be unique to others worldwide. It will integrate multiple CTO member countries, promote homes in each destination, and links to each country's website. Airbnb has also pledged to share data with the CTO, including travel trends, to facilitate informed marketing decisions during this recovery period. Director of Tourism Pamela Yui stated, quote, "The Turks and Caicos Islands Tourist Board is excited to partner once again with Airbnb through the Caribbean Tourism Organization to feature the best that the destination has to offer. The vacation rental market has grown significantly over the past few years, and this campaign affords us the opportunity to promote our beautiful by nature islands in a key source market, the northeast of the United States. We look forward to welcoming travelers to the Turks and Caicos Islands and feel confident that our protocol under the TCI Assured program allow us to safely host visitors. These measures are proving successful at not only protecting our visitors, but also our residents. This allows guests to focus on enjoying the exceptional vacation experience afforded by the destination, our picturesque beaches, and our world-class hospitality partners." End quote. The joint undertaking with the CTO builds on Airbnb's commitment to help strengthen communities in the Caribbean in tough times. Airbnb Policy Manager for Central America and the Caribbean, Carlos Munoz, stated, quote, "With the Caribbean continuing to reopen, we're helping to usher in the safe return of travel to this wonderful region by shining a light on the many places to see and things to do. We are also excited to promote the important economic impact driven by hosting on Airbnb," end quote. Acting Secretary General of the CTO Neil Walters shared, quote, "This partnership is one of the many initiatives in the CTO's ongoing program to help its members rebuild tourism in their destination. The partnership with Airbnb will help us to promote the region responsibly by providing our members with a platform to showcase their destinations, while at the same time highlighting the health safety measures that each has implemented to ensure that visitors can enjoy a safe Caribbean experience during this time." And
a break now, but the weather is up when we come back.
In order to auto-scan your PTV set-top box, you need to follow these basic steps. Turn on your television and set-top box. Press menu on the remote control. Choose installation and press OK. Enter password, press 0000. Choose auto search and press OK. Go down to start search and press OK. Choose yes and press OK. The box will start searching for channels until process bar reach 100%. Click on exit and data will be saved. Click on exit again to continue enjoying the PTV experience. Thank you for supporting the PTV network.
A mixed weather pattern across the island. Here's your weather forecast for Tuesday, March 23rd. In Grand Turk, intervals of clouds and sunshine. High 79, low 74. Winds ease at 15 to 25 miles per hour. South Caicos, partly cloudy skies. High 79, low 74. Winds ease at 20 to 30 miles per hour. Northern Middle Caicos, partly cloudy skies. High 79, low 73. Winds east-southeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. Part and Pine Key, partly cloudy skies. High 79, low 73. Winds east-southeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. And on Providence Yalish, partly cloudy skies. High 79, low 73. Winds east-southeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. For your sunrise and sunset. Sunrise 6:51 a.m. Sunset 7:02 p.m. A look now at your high tide and low tide. High tide 3:43 a.m. 4:14 p.m. Low tide 10:16 a.m. 10:14 p.m. And that's it for your weather forecast. We'll be right back with more on Newswatch.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providence Jollies, Mighty's Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. Yet another illegal sloop has made landfall in the TCI. Hear how many illegal migrants were intercepted in this batch in this next story. Following the coastal radar system's detection, an illegal vessel containing 140 irregular migrants was successfully intercepted on Sunday, March 21, at 1:13 a.m. by the Marine Branch Unit. The blue and red 50-foot vessel had 108 Haitian men and 32 Haitian women on board. The Marine Branch Sea Guardian, with the assistance of the Sea Pursuit, intercepted the vessel southwest of Wheelie Point. The illegal vessel was towed to the South Dock port, where the detainees were handed over to immigration officials for processing and repatriation. The operation was conducted without incident. Over the weekend, the TCI recorded its 16th COVID-19-related death. That person is an elderly patient who was known to be infected with COVID-19. The patient passed away at the Cockburn Town Medical Center in Grand Turk during the early morning hours of Saturday, March 28. The patient was admitted to the medical center in critical condition, and their condition deteriorated rapidly. The next of kin have already been notified. The TCI Hospital and the Ministry of Health is reminding the general public to practice the relevant public health measures to suppress the spread of COVID-19. The public is also reminded that if they have symptoms suggestive of COVID-19, to please stay home and contact the Ministry of Health hotline numbers. Do not visit healthcare facilities if you have symptoms or signs of COVID-19. If your symptoms are severe, please call 911 or consult with your healthcare provider regarding the COVID-19 vaccine. That brings us to the end of another newscast. Thank you so much for tuning in. We do appreciate your company. To view more content, visit us at www.ptv8tci.com or join us every weekday at 6:30 p.m. I am Delana Alves. See you next time.